The two MPs were today summoned through the office of the Speaker of Parliament. According to the summons from the Directorate of Criminal Investigations, the MPs are wanted for their alleged involvement in the killing of at least 26 people by machete-wielding thugs in the Greater Masaka region. Both Seglinya and Sewanyana, who claim to have been out of the country, have denied any knowledge in the criminality in Masaka.
If this is the stage now where we are in the politics of Uganda, that we practice politics of blackmail, smear, defamation, it is very unbelievable.
I'm not aware of this thing. I've been not around. I'm not connected to this group. I don't know the group even.
The Criminal Investigations Directorate spokesperson Charles Twine confirmed the summons.
Yeah, the summons are authentic. They were duly signed by our officer here. And because of their status in society, we thought it was so courteous to serve them through the speaker, and actually to respect part of their privilege. These are members of parliament whom we treat with respect.
But I will answer them because my hands are very clean. I've never participated in such a kind of activity. I have not even been around.
I will go, but I will say nothing. Because I just mentioned my name, that I'm called Seglinya Wamadi, MP representing Kawempe North. Now I can't add any other statement.
The summons came just hours after a meeting between MPs from Buganda Region and the Internal Affairs Minister Jeno Kahindo Tafire on the situation in Masaka. In the meeting, they agreed to avoid politicizing the situation.
I've told them that we should work together. Those who are willing to work with us, those who are willing to work with us are welcome. Those who are not willing, they will have to explain to their constituents. I don't want them to accuse us of not involving them in the effort to pacify and bring peace. Pacify Masaka, bring peace, pacify and bring peace in Masaka.
If there are people who want to gain support and to remove government through other means, you can't go and machete them, kill them, and at the same time seek for their support. So for us, we urge government to desist in putting on the political spectacles on this matter.
Because how can you say it is the elected leaders who are killing their own voters? How can you kill your own voters? People who voted you to me, I say, if I'm to answer him in the same currency, I would say then it is those who are not voted.
But as security zeroes in on politicians, there are conflicting voices accusing individuals in security circles of being behind the murders.
And the pointers we have, especially to some insiders that could be behind it, we've been that frank. And it did not sound completely ignorant, although it never confirmed. It didn't sound like, oh, I don't know, but it sounded as if he has a clue about it.
So far, 10 people have been arraigned before the High Court in Masaka and remanded at Saza prisons for allegedly committing the murders. This all comes on the heels of an admission by the Masaka Resident State Commissioner Katerega Musazi that the situation has calmed down. He said no deaths have been reported, although 2 more people have been picked up in Sembabule for allegedly planning attacks there.
Now, one was suspected when his number was tracked, his telephone number was tracked. Then the other one was heard as conspiring with some other people on phone. Then the hotel or the lodge ward, the mate reported to security immediately.
Habad Ziwa, NTV Weekend Edition.